The perception of tinnitus can be greatly influenced by our somatosensory system, especially by neck or jaw complaints. Of all tinnitus patients, up to 25% experience a strong influence from neck or jaw problems on their tinnitus, and they can often achieve significant tinnitus relief by following appropriate forms of physiotherapy. The problem is that these patients, suffering from so-called somatosensory tinnitus, are rarely correctly identified. Currently, this diagnosis can only be made by select, trained specialists, which prevents many patients from getting the necessary treatment. To facilitate this diagnosis, we've launched an online survey in September 2019. Almost 8,000 tinnitus patients, hailing from all over the world, filled out our survey. Based on this big data set, we've developed a model to identify patients with and without somatosensory tinnitus. 20% of our data set was used to test model performance, while optimization of the model was performed in a five-fold cross-validation. Ultimately, we have created a decision tree to classify patients with and without somatosensory tinnitus. Based on only four self-reported parameters, this model was able to separate patients with an accuracy of over 80%. A crucial parameter turned out to be whether tinnitus and neck or jaw complaints increased or decreased simultaneously. Next, our classification is dependent on tension in the suboccipital muscles, the ability to modulate tinnitus with certain movements, and the presence or absence of teeth clenching. Based on a big data set, we've developed a decision tree to classify somatosensory tinnitus patients with a high accuracy. This straightforward tool can now be readily used in a clinical setting to aid the diagnosis of somatosensory tinnitus.